In this video documentation, I'm going to walk you through the messaging and schedule task feature within Empower. Now, in case you're not familiar with this particular feature, messaging and schedule tasks allows you to do a great number of things within Empower. For instance, you can schedule summaries. So as you know, you have a data warehousing piece and maybe you have four summaries that need to run every night. So you could schedule those within schedule tasks and have those run automatically. You could also schedule reports in the same way as well. So if you had some reports that we're going to create per HTML file that you were going to save out on your Empower server, you could schedule that. To dovetail that, you could also email these reports. So again, whether it's on a scheduled entry or you wanted to execute it tied to a maintenance application, you could email reports through our feature as well. As I mentioned before, you could schedule these and run every minute, every hour, every day. Really, you have a total customization to the frequency that these jobs are going to run. You can save applications to the server themselves. So again, whether they're HTML files, PDFs, or if you wanted to merge data with a PDF form that you already had, schedule tasks and messaging allows you to do that. You could even upload a spreadsheet automatically as well. And as I mentioned just a moment ago, you can trigger activities also through maintenance actions as well. So after a record is added, updated, or deleted, you can trigger that through, you can trigger a messaging event through the maintainer. And last but not least, you can even do things like sending text messages as well through this particular utility. So there's quite a bit you can accomplish within messaging and schedule tasks. And rather than go through all of them with you here in a very long video, you can check out the link that's on the screen here, and that will take you to our documentation specifically for messaging and schedule tasks, where we've created a series of videos depending on what specific feature you're interested in. But just to give you a very brief overview, let me go ahead and jump in. You can access messaging and schedule tasks via the admin area and clicking messaging and schedule tasks. So there are four areas in here that we're going to go through, and we'll go through these pretty quickly. Tasks and task groups, that's where we're going to do most of our work here. But once we create a group, we can schedule it. And depending on what we're looking to do, you can even specify output folders. So if you wanted these files that are being created, if you're choosing to do that, you can choose where they go out on the Empower server. And then messaging and configuration does need to be completed here. And we have a video specifically for messaging configuration. So I'm going to jump into task and task groups. And you can see right now I have no task groups. So a task group is like a parent element, and then the task is its child. So when we go to execute a task group, that's really how we have to do it. As a task group, all of the tasks, all of the children themselves come along with that particular task group. So I can say add a new task group. So I can just call this sample and give it a description if I wanted. And I can choose to put it in test mode. The value of putting it in test mode, if you're sending out emails, you know, to a list of customers or salesmen, and you may want to test it out first before it goes out live. So you could choose enable test mode, and you can specify what email address should get all of the activity. So you can have some control there, but in my case here, we can go ahead and leave that unchecked. So great, I have my task group. Now I want to create an individual task within it. So I'm going to click add task. And here you can see is a list of all of those different tasks types that I went through in the beginning video with the card that was on display. They're showing you all of the different options. For the moment, I'm going to do probably the most popular one, which is just email a report. So I can say what exactly I want to call this. So I'm going to call this email state sales info. And if I had more than one task, this is really important, I can control what order my tasks are run in. And that's really necessary if you have a summary, and then, you know, that creates a table, and then you have a report built over that table. You would certainly want to run the summary before you ran the report. In my case, I'm only going to have one, so I can leave this here as a task sequence number of 0. So we've created the task type. Now we're going to go in and say what application we want to run. So in our case, we want to call a report, and it's going to be sales by state report. I can pass in additional parameters if I wanted to. And if you're not familiar with what those parameters are, you can use this helper here to help control which things you wanted. So if I wanted to add sorting, I could choose what I wanted to sort by and things like that. And if I click, it will let me pick based on what's in the application. So if I wanted to sort by state, I could do that. And I could say append parameter. And it adds it in there for me, which is really nice. I can choose whether or not I want to send this as an attachment. By default, it'll embed it into the email. Otherwise, I can say send as attachment. And if I choose to send it as an attachment, I do have to give it a file name. For the moment, I'm going to just embed it in the email, and I'll say save and proceed. And then Empower wants to know, well, who should get this email? So I already have a distribution list set up. Again, that's a retrieval type application, and it's just a list of email addresses that should get my email here. So I'm going to choose my distribution list, and I can map fields here. It's optional depending on a good reason for that is if you know, in our case here, we're going to send out a report with state info, and if I have multiple users and they should only get certain states, I could make that mapping here, but it is optional. For the moment, I'll say save and proceed, and then I can put in some information like a subject, could be test email. I could give it a message. The message would only be shown if it's as an attachment. If you're embedding it in the email, there would be no message. And you can attach additional files as well if you wanted to do that. So I'll say save, and I will click finish. You can see now my task group is built with the individual task therein. So we're not going to talk about this too much, but there are three ways to invoke a task group. One is via clicking this test button. Another would be tying this to a maintenance application. And then the third would be scheduling it. So I'll have a video at that same link that I talked about before that will show you how to do each of those things. For the sake of brevity, I can just click here to send the email. I can click this test button. It will go out and it will invoke the job. And when it's done, it's going to send me back some debugging information. It's going to say who's gotten the email and as well as what application was sent. So if we jump over to my email, I can see that sure enough, here is my test email with the data that was requested. Again, this is a simple example embedded. We could have done as an attachment, but I wanted you to see how simple it was to be able to create a schedule task entry and to be able to invoke it and have it sent out here into my email. Please check out the other videos in this series. They'll go into a little deeper dive in terms of the details. Otherwise, please let us know if you have questions.